أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming. جزا الله خير everyone who is viewers seeing us from any place in the whole world inshallah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it in our balance in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Still with the halaqat of important of as-salah. And also at the same time going to the opposite of it, which it is in Arabic, at-targhib wa at-targhib. At-targhib giving you the attraction. What will you get when you pray? Also Allah Azza wa Jalla use what will you be punished, how you will be punished, and how much punishment you will get if you don't do. For that in between both of them, the mu'min will get with the attraction and will be yani, love to do it. But as I told you, after the prayer, the first thing will be done for you in Islam. When you were born, azan in the right ear. Azan for what? For salah. To say to you, even you are only just 1 hour. Just you born. Say to you, hayya ala salah. Salah is very important. And iqama in the left ear. And the last thing before we bury anybody, last thing, before right away we bury him, must be the Salat al-Janazah. Salah also. For that between the Adhan, at the beginning of your board, till the last minute, all of it should be Salah. Should be Salah. The only one pillar in Islam. Have no any excuse in Islam at all. At all. No any kind of excuse. Will never be forgiven. Zakah could be if there is no money. Siyam could be if you are not able by a certified Muslim doctor saying to you that it will harm you then. But not because of the bills. Because bills you can exchange it instead of the daytime, put it at the night time. Suppose 6 hours or every 4 or 5 hours at the night. While you are sleeping in the normal days, you will not take. For that exchange it. For that fasting, even you don't do it for a Shari'i reason, still, you have a chance to go to Jannah and you are forgiven and there is no any sin upon you and there is no any problem at all. Hajj, there is no money, no Hajj. And this is one of the main pillars of Islam. Salah, have no any excuse at all. You have to do it. Why? Because the Salah comes inshallah later. Salah, one of the pillars of Islam, contain all. In the Salah, there is part of Al-Hajj, we direct our face to Al-Ka'bah. This is part of Al-Hajj. In the Salah also, you cannot eat. This is part of Siyam. You are fasting while you are praying. In the Salah also, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Or that the Shahada. Shahada is there. Hajj is there. Fasting is there. What else? Zakah. Zakah is يعني, branch of the time. How you do Zakah? When you work, and the work is part of the time. According to the time, you get the money. Okay, right? And you get the zakah out of the time you spend for some money. You already not only spending, yani paying the money in the salah, you paying the original of the money, which it is the time. In the zakah, you pay the money, right? Money is part of time. Money is a result of time. In the salah, you are not doing the zakah of money. You are doing zakah by the time itself, because you spend some time in the salah for Allah. For that the Salah have contain whole, and explain more later inshallah, contain whole pillars of Islam. And we stopped the last time's hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying the most heaviest prayer upon munafiqeen, hypocrite, to ask Allah save us, Fajr and Isha. Fajr and Isha. And al-Fatiha divided between you and Allah. Every single thing you say in al-Fatiha, Allah will answer you. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah will say, Hamadani Abdi. الرحمن الرحيم مجدني عبدي مالك يوم الدين مجدني وأثنى علي عبدي أو مجدني عبدي إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين الله عز وجل will say هذا بيني وبين عبدي ولعبدي ما سأل. This is between me and my slave and for my slave whatever he asked. And Allah Azza wa Jalla in Surah Al-Ma'arij, الإنسان خلق هلوعا, very impatient. إذا مسه الشر جزوعا, from some evil touch him, he will be يعني irritable, discontented, not happy, worried. وإذا مسه الخير منوعا, when good touched him, he will be niggardly, he will lose hold and will not spend في سبيل الله. Allah عز وجل make exception from all of those إلا المصلين. Human being is very impatient. Musallin will be patient. Have sabr. The salah will bring the sabr to you. إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا, when he touched by any evil, he will be fear and he will be discontent and he will be not happy. But the one who's brave, he will be happy. Even with the evil. Because he knows this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With the sabr and shukr, being shakir and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when goodness happened to him, he will be thankful. For the evil, he will be sabr. And with the bad, he will be shakir. With the good, he will be shakir. And with the evil, he will be sabir. Between sabr and shukr, he will be subhanallah. For that Allah said, illa al-musallin, but not every musalli. This is our halaqa today. Hadith of Allah Azza wa Jal, hadith Qudsi. Laysa kullu musallin yusalli. Laysa kullu musallin yusalli. And I'll explain it, inshaAllah. For that Allah Azza wa Jal said, illa al-musallin, whom ya Allah, alladhina hum ala salatihim da'imun. Those who continuously pray, not in one line and leave five lines, in one day and leave another day, it's one prayer and neglect the rest. No. دائمون. They pray in the time. They remain constant. They do it as it should be done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وقول النبي, give a glad tidings to those who go to the masajid in the darkness, that you will have full and complete light at the day of judgment. For that, here the last ayah was to with Surah Al-Hadid. When المنافقون المنافقات men and women, they will say to the believers, let us get some of your light. انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم قيل ارجعوا وراءكم. Go back to your rear. You will find some. Seek some of the light. Seek some of the light. Then, عليكم السلام, then a wall will be put in between both of them. Then from one of the side of the wall will be rahma, the other side will be azab. Rahma for the believer, for those who pray, for those who know Allah Azza wa Jal, for those who follow Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, azab for munafiqeen, for hypocrites. And Allah mentioned in it that they will say, Alam nakum ma'akum. We already was with you. With munafiqeen, always they pray with the prayer, with the people who pray, even at the time of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Wasn't we was with you at the day of dunya? They will say yes. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ فَتَنْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. You put yourself in a fitna. You put yourself in temptation. You put yourself in trials. You put yourself in a problem when you don't pray. وَتَرَبَّصْتُمْ. And you look forward for the problems for other. وَارْتَبْتُمْ. Have doubt. For that in Islam, doubt is not allowed. Doubtful and being doubtful. As I'm saying, sometimes the people laugh. I say some of the people, even they shake the other hand. Shake the other hand of the man for salam. After he, out of the doubt he has, he will count his fingers. Out of the doubt he has, he will count his fingers. Does he steal some of the amazing, akhi. Too much doubt is wrong. It's not allowed. Rizat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say here, وَارْتَبْتُمْ وَغَرَّتْكُمُ الْأَمَانِينَ. You was deceived by the false wishes for a wrong desires. حَتَّى جَاءَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ وَغَرَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. Until the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, and he was deceived by the shaitan in respect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us move now to Salatul Asr, for Asr prayer. What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ مَنْ تَرَكَ صَلَاةَ الْعَصْرِ فَكَأَنَّهُ وَتِرَى. فروه كأنما وتر أهله وماله. وتر بمعنى فقد أهله وماله. Whoever neglect صلاة العصر as if he lost his family and his money. Imagine if you lost your family and your money in one time. Will you feel sad? صلاة العصر, any صلاة عصر, you lose it, equal to that. So that this is the reason Allah Azza wa Jal say, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Take care and guard the five daily prayer, especially the middle salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الصلاة الوسطى صلاة العصر. The middle salah is Salat al-Asr. And go to any masjid. You will find big numbers in al-Fajr sometime, in al-Zuhr sometime, in al-Maghrib sometime, some masajid, different prayer. Isha. The one agreed upon between all masajid, al-Asr. You will find two people, sometime nobody. Neglect. Allah knows that shortening will be in the Muslim Ummah, for that He say, take care of your salah, especially the middle salah. Don't neglect it. Time of coming out of the job, and time of being tired, and time of going here, catching the bank, I don't know million reason. For that you'll find masajid in majority of the masajid. In Asr prayer, find the least number. Go any masjid, you will see. At the time itself, which it is a time fixed, not at the time of the azan, or always fixed after it. And still, for that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, take care of your salah, keep guarding it, do it in the time, and especially the middle salah, salatul asr. Whoever neglected, as if he lost his family and his money. وفي البخاري عن أبي موسى الأشعري قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من ضيع صلاة العصر فقد حابط عمله. This is more warning. More warning from رسول الله. Whoever neglect صلاة العصر until get out of the time of it, he destroy all of his good deeds. He destroyed by losing the عصر, he destroying all of the good deeds. As if it is, it will not be acceptable except if you do that, Salat al-Asr in its time. About Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Isha, in Sahihain, al-Bukhari wa Muslim, and Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, ليس صلاةٌ أثقل على المنافقين من صلاة الفجر وصلاة العشاء. The heaviest prayer upon the hypocrite. We ask Allah save us from any hypocrisy. Go back to the halaqat of the kufr, halaqat of the nifaq, hypocrisy, halaqat of the shirk in order to learn. In order to avoid shirk, to avoid kufr, to avoid nifaq, you have to know it. And you have to know the qualities of munafiqeen. Otherwise, you will be in it while you don't feel it. Sahaba, the best of the people at the time of Rasulullah, they used to ask each other, Atara fiya nifaqan? Do you see any kind of hypocrisy in me? Because nifaq is not only one kind, too many. Here, the most heaviest prayer, abun al-munafiqeen, Fajr and Isha. Fajr and Isha. وفي رواية أخرى قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى الفجر 40 يوما كتبت له براءة من النفاق. Whoever pray the Fajr 40 day, in another narration لا تفوته تكبيرة الإحرام. Does not miss تكبيرة الإحرام, the first تكبيرة for the men in جماعة. Whoever pray the Fajr 40 days in جماعة, does not miss تكبيرة الإحرام, will be written to him innocent and purity and clean from nifaq. This is one of the reward of it. وفي رواية أخرى قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى البردين أي الفجر والصبح والعصر دخل الجنة. Not only that no nifaq in him, no, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say whoever pray and taking care of the two prayer, الفجر and العصر, he will enter الجنة. But also by the way, just I remember it for that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say من أكل ثوما أو بصلا فليعتزل مصلانا. وفي رواية أخرى من أكل من هاتان الشجرتان الخبيثتان أي الخبيثتان الرائحة فلا يقربن مصلانا. Whoever eat of these two trees, which it is the onion and the garlic, he should not come pray with us. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was saying that. That means the bad smell is very important to avoid it. Sometimes bad smell out of the sacks. يعوذ بالله. Worse than the onion and garlic. Million time. Wallahi, from the door of the masjid. For that, take care of it. Yeah, take it out. Why you are stuck with it? Wash your legs for the doing mass. Well, it is have a very bad smell. In the winter, you will not feel nothing. But in the summer. In the summer, wallahi, sometime, as a place of sujood, sometime I'll go to vomit out of the, when he stand at the place, the sacks will make that smell in the place of sujood. Then you leave, somebody come, praying at the same place, and come his problem is his face in the same place of your feet. Yeah, very bad. Not only that also, but should nobody know, should not be offended. Smoking. For those who think smoking is makruh, they are wrong. Smoking is haram. Smoking is haram, because also when you come, the smoking smell will be, the smoke will be, everybody will be insulted with it. When you smoke it, the mouse will bring the smell. But is it not, this is out of the topic, sorry for that, but for something important. It is haram. Fatwa of the Mufti of Egypt, he say, Al-Sajairu, Al-Tadkhin, Manqoo'u Al-Khamr. The cigarette itself made out of tobacco. That kind of leaves, tobacco, never catch fire, except if they put it in a wine, for at least 2 years. Again, the cigarette inside it, the one wrapped with the white stuff inside it, is something that's named tabagh, a leaves of kind of a plant. That kind tobacco, that kind never catch fire. Even you put it in fire, will never catch, except if you put it in a wine for at least 2 years. Then after that, they dry. They go processing for the factory of the smoking. They know that very well. Then after that, they go for that. It is already having some wine. In Arabic, manqoo al-khamr, kal-khamr. For that, it is forbidden other than the calamities it brings. They write to you in every packet that at-tadkhinu darrun jiddan bis-sihha. It is very harmful to your body, to your health. The first reason for cancer, if you go to for any doctor, cancer doctor, first reason will ask you, do you smoke? If you say no, anybody around you smoke? If you say no, anybody of the parent from father's side or mother's side was smoking? Because this is the main point and the main reason of the cancer, walayhazu billah. Cancer for the lung, cancer for the throat, cancer for the Adam's apple, whatever. For that, it is forbidden. Why you destroy your money? It's not only makruh. For that, the smell of it also, this I go back to our topic, is not only onions, is not only the garlic. What about, yes, for the question come always about that, what about onions and garlic cooked? No problem with the cooked one. We're talking about the raw. We're talking about the raw. Because the cooked one have no smell. Rasulullah was talking about the smell of it. It harms the people and it also annoys the angels. But if it is cooked, because most of the cooking contain onion and contain garlic. No problem with that at all. We are talking about if you eat it raw and smell is still there, then this one will harm others. For that, Rasulullah SAW saying that should not. Here, Rasulullah SAW said, taking care of the prayer, what about if I didn't do tawbah? Taking care of the prayer and somebody does not do for some time, do tawbah. And tawbah means never ever neglect the prayer and take care of it and do it in its time. Now we'll move to Hadith Qudsi. In Musnad al-Bazzar, والمجروحين لابن حبان ذات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سي الله عز وجل سيد ليس كل مصل يصلي. This is a very 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 important. ليس كل مصل يصلي. Not everybody who is praying is actually praying. He is doing the ruku and doing the sujood, but actually he is not praying. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I'll explain more. ليس كل مصل يصلي. Not everybody who is doing the ruku and the sujood and standing, he is doing actual prayer. Or with another way, not everybody doing a prayer, his prayer will be acceptable. Allah Azza wa Jal say, إِنَّمَا أَتَقَبَّلُ الصَّلَاةَ مِمَّنْ تَوَاضَعَ بِهَا لِعَظَمَتِي. I will accept the prayer from the one who do it with khushu and khudu for Allah Azza wa Jal. I will accept the prayer from the one who do it with khushu', with khudu', with humbleness, with concentration. In another narration, وَلَمْ يَسْتَطِلْ بِهَا عَلَىٰ خَلْقِي. In this hadith, the condition of accepting the prayer. Number one, not everybody praying is actually praying. This is what Rasulullah SAW said, what Allah Azza wa Jal said. Check your prayer, are you doing it perfect and complete or not? Number one of the condition of it is that Allah Azza wa Jal said, I will accept it from the one who do it humbly, simply. You do it as it should be done. For that, if you do not do it as it should be done, as the man who is doing so fast, ruku' and sujood, Allah Azza, Rasulullah SAW say, go repeat and repeat your prayer. You did not pray. وَلَمْ يَسْتَطِلْ بِهَا عَلَىٰ خَلْقِ. Does not get arrogant by doing it. If you do arrogant by doing it, you are not doing right. Thinking that, okay, I'm praying means I'm a prophet. No. Because Allah knows if it is acceptable or not. وَكَفَّ شَهَوَاتُهُ. Be acceptable from. كَفَّ شَهَوَاتُهُ عَنْ مَحَارِمِهِ. He control his bad desires. His salah will be acceptable. But what about if he's praying and still he's doing haram? He's praying and he's backbite. He's praying and do all wrong. Then it's not, as the hadith saying, لَيْسَ كُلُّ مُصَلِّنْ يُصَلِّي. Not everybody doing the prayer is actually doing it, is actually accepted from him. وَلَمْ يُصِرْ عَلَى مَعْصِيَتِي. For one of the conditions of accepting the prayer, he does not insist upon disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For another narration, وَقَطَعَ نَهَارَهُ فِي ذِكْرِي. One of the conditions of accepting the prayer. Look, it is like a circle. If your prayer is acceptable, you will do zikr of Allah. And if you do zikr of Allah, your prayer will be acceptable. Everyone result of it, the other one. For that one of the conditions here, that he does the zikr of Allah. وَأَطْعَمَ الْجَائِعَ. And he feeds the one who is hungry. وَكَسَ الْعُرْيَانِ. And he gives clothes to the one who does not have. وَرَحِمَ الْمُصَابِ. And he is merciful to the one who has some calamity. وَآوَ الْغَرِيبَ. And he guessed the one, who make a guess the one who is strange, somebody traveling or that, or something like that. كُلُّ, this is a very important point. كُلُّ ذَلِكَ لِي. Doing it sincerely, الإخلاص, for Allah Azza wa Jal. Because if doing the prayer show off, no prayer he had. Doing spending the money, not في سبيل الله, في سبيل الشيطان, will never be acceptable. Even he thinks that he is doing for Allah Azza wa Jal. Or that the end of it is that he is doing that sincerely for the sake of Allah. Not for show off, not for your own ego, not for the sake of the people, not for Allah and for others. Remember the hadith I said before? That when somebody asked Rasulullah, I am doing jihad في سبيل الله, for Allah and for the people also to praise me. قال لا شيء لك. You will never get anything. Then Allah in this hadith saying, وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي. By my glory, by my majesty, إِنَّ نُورَ وَجْهَهُ عِنْدِي لَأَضْوَأُ مِنْ نُورِ الشَّمْسِ. The light coming out of the face of the one, his salah is acceptable, more stronger than the light of the sun. Imagine, subhanAllah, more stronger and more beautiful than the light of the sun itself. عَلَىٰ أَنْ أَجْعَلَ الْجَهَالَةَ لَهُ حِلْمًا. Allah Azza wa Jal say, I will change the ignorant, he have to be not ignorant, will be haleem, will be forbearing, will be patient. وَالظُّلْمَةُ نُورًا. If you do the prayer perfectly, the darkness you have will change to light. Then look to the result if you do. يَدْعُونِي فَأُلَبِّيَهُ. Allah Azza wa Jal say that when he asks, I will answer. يَسْأَلُنِي فَأُعْطِيَهُ. When he needs, I will give it to him. وَيُقْسِمُ عَلَيَّ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَأَبَرُّ. When he swear by the name of Allah, Allah will make it to be heaven. أَكْلَأُهُ بِقُرْبِي. I will take care of him and I'll cover his need by my nearness to him. Nearness by his knowledge, not by him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he's over al-arsh. وَأَسْتَحْفِظُهُ مَلَائِكَتِي. I will order my angel to take care of him, to protect him, to serve him. مِثْلُهُ عِنْدِي كَمِثْلُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ لَا يُمَسُّ ثَمَرُهَا. His example with me is like the garden. Nothing can touch it. And the fruits of it not be touched. وَلَا يَتَغَيَّرُ حَالُهَا. And good all the time does not change. Let us go step by step. Allah Azza wa Jal, with the explanation of this hadith, Allah Azza wa Jal saying, some of the hadith, saying, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Salah must prevent you from all kind of fahsha and munkar, from all kind of haram, from all kind of wrong, from all kind of mistake, from all kind of major sin. Salah prevent you from that. And when Allah says that, there is no any doubt it is true. What about if you pray and you still commit the major sin? Rasulullah answered, مَنْ لَمْ تَنْهَهُ. Rasulullah said, مَنْ لَمْ تَنْهَهُ صَلَاتُهُ عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ فَلَا صَلَاةَ لَهُ. Whoever his salah does not prevent him from committing الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ, from committing the haram, from committing the sin, from committing the major sin, then he have no salah. Something wrong. Either the wudu is not right, or the istinja is not right, or the salah itself he does not do as it should be done. He do it so fast, ruku' so fast, and sujood so fast, in 1 second he finished 50 rak'ah. How Allah knows? Or that whoever his salah does not prevent him from committing al-fahsha' wal-munkar, he have no salah. And this is the meaning of the first part of the hadith. لَيْسَ كُلُّ مُصَلِّنْ يُصَلِّي. Not everybody praying is actually his prayer acceptable, or actually he is praying. He is not. Why? doing is a prayer while you are committing the fahsha wal munkar, and Allah says that it should prevent you, and it does not prevent you, laysa kullu musallin yusalli. Not everybody praying is doing actually prayer. Yes, doing by doing the ruku and standing, and, but the pillars does not do it perfectly. The sunan of the prayer itself inside it does not do it. This is if he did. And maybe they did good, and sujood is long, and the ruku' is long, but not sincerely for the sake of Allah. No concentration in it. While he is praying, remember the story of Shafi'i. When the man came to him and he said, where is my money? He said, okay, go pray whole night. Shaitan never leave him from the first rak'ah. For that, if you are in the prayer, and your mind is busy with million things, not with Allah, not in your grave, not what will you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not about al-hisab, not about al-iqab, not about al-jannah, not about al-nar, busy about everything other than that, about the food and about the business, about the money, about the bank, about, then, ليس كل مصلي يصلي. Firstly, I already explained many halaqat about take care of your prayer. Now we'll come to the one who is praying actually, that do not think that خلاص, alhamdulillah, I am in the sky. No. ليس كل مصلي فمن لم تنه صلاته عن الفحشاء والمنكر لم يزدد من الله إلا بعدا. If your salah does not prevent you from all haram and wrong, this salah itself, instead of make you near to Allah and close to Allah, no, it will make you farther. Because it's not acceptable. Because it's not done right. Because you didn't do as it should be done. In another narration, فَلَا صَلَاةَ لَهِ فَلَا صَلَاةَ لَهِ, you have no prayer. In كنز العمال عن أنس قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, المسند الشهاب also, مَنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَرَعٌ يَصُدُّهُ عَنْ مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إِذَا خَلَى أي خَلَى بِنَفْسِهِ لَمْ يَعْبَئِ اللَّهُ بِسَائِرُ عَمَلِهِ. If there is no taqwa, if there is no piety and righteousness, if there is no haya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to feel shy from Allah, to commit the mistakes while you are alone, while you are nobody seeing you. Because some of the people, in front of the people, they will be good, but when they are alone by themselves, a'udhu billahi minash shaitan, worse than shayateen. If there is no any taqwa to prevent you from doing, committing the wrong while you are yourself, Allah will not look to the rest of your good deeds. Allah will not, because you're already doing with the worst. For that, salah was a show-off. Salah while you are cheating. Salah while you are lying. Salah while you are betraying. Salah while you are backbiting. Salah while you are doing facade between the people, corruption and troubles. Hating everybody. Salah does not prevent you. Then, laysa kullu musallin yusalli. The beginning of the hadith. Not everybody praying is actually praying. Now you understand that expression, because it is when you say not everybody praying is not actually praying, sometimes will not be understanding. But when you know that when you are praying while you are doing all kind of haram, all kind of wrong, and smoking, and drugs, and, then even you are praying, you are not actually praying. That prayer is not correct. That prayer is not perfect. Because if it is perfect and correct and complete and right and done as it should be done, it must prevent you from that. If it is done and it's done not preventing you from committing the haram, preventing you from backbiting, does not prevent you from, then ليس كل مصلي يصلي. You know the hadith in Bukhari, when the man was praying in front of Rasulullah, just the mistake he did, he did it fast. Not committing all of this while he is praying. No, just he did it fast. Rasulullah said, go repeat your prayer. Second time, go repeat. Third time, go repeat. Fourth time. He said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi la uhsinu ghayra hadha. I do not know more better than what I'm doing. Then Rasulullah start, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, explaining to him, go to the halaqat of, sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as you see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praying, halaqat of the explanation of the salah from A to Z. You will know the difference between what of the some people doing and what actually should be done. For that here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he sees somebody not only praying fast, doing all kind of committing of all haram, then ليس كل مصلي يصلي. Not everybody praying is actually prayer or his prayer. Now, there is a very important point relating to the halaqat of Sunday. Halaqat of Sunday about the kufr and about the fisq now. Is it allowed to say to anybody, you are a kafir directly? No, it's not allowed. It's not good to do. For that also, if somebody is already praying and you know that's some mistake, can you say to him, your prayer is not acceptable? No. Because this is in the hand of Allah Azza wa Jal. Correct your own self. Take care of your own self. Don't worry about others. And if you want to advise others, advise with the wisdom, with the al-hikmah, with the maw'izah al-hasana, with the good advice. Because you don't know. Maybe you are doing the same mistake while you don't feel it, while you don't know it. InshaAllah, the next time, we will go with the next part of the hadith. إِنَّمَا أَتَقَبَّرُ الصَّلَاةَ مِمَّنْ تَوَاضَعَ بِهَا لِعَظَمَتِهِ. I will accept the salah from the one who is doing it as it should be done for the honoring of Allah, for the respect of Allah, for the glory of Allah, as it should be done to you to Allah Azza wa Jalla. This is inshallah will be the next time. Allahumma afir lana dhunubana, Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina, Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar, Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husna ibadatik, Allahumma arhamna fa innaka bina rahim, wa la tu'adhibna fa anta alayna qadir, walatuf bina ya maulana fima jarat bihi al-maqadir, wansurna wa la tansur alayna wa a'inna wa la tu'in alayna, wansurna ala man baga alayna wa ahdina wa yassir al-huda ilayna, وارحمنا فإنك بنا رحم يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. وانصر من نصرنا واخذل من خذلنا ووفقنا يا رب العالمين. واجعلنا وأبنائنا وبناتنا وذرياتنا من بعدنا محافظين على الصلاة يا رب العالمين، مقيمين للصلاة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام والإكرام، مؤدين للزكاة يا حي يا قيوم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية. اللهم ارزقنا قلوبا تقية نقية لا كافرة ولا شقية. واهدي أبناءنا وبناتنا، اللهم اهدي أبناءنا وبناتنا لما فيه رضاك يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم المخزون المكنون الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت، وإذا سئلت به أعطيت، وإذا استرحمت به رحمت. ترحمنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء. نسألك الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. And I'm asking everybody by the great name of Allah, always remember me in the best and my family in the best of your dua. ورزانا ورزاكم الله خيرا. And the angel will return the same dua to you. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.